So in some previous videos, I've explored the idea that ultimate reality, which is outside of space and time, is where the digital universe is manufactured or created. That as body minds and biological organisms and objects, we are the product of a digital workshop in cosmic consciousness outside of space and time. So let me explore this idea with you. So at the most fundamental level of existence, the difference between entities, be they objects, organisms, or members of a species, the most fundamental level of existence, the difference between all these entities, objects, organisms, members of a species can be reduced to digital information. This concept suggests that as material objects, we are in essence innumerable combinations of zeros and ones. While this notion might seem abstract or even counterintuitive, it merits careful consideration as it interacts with various fields of study and has profound implications for our understanding of reality. First of all, there's a quantum foundation to this. To comprehend this idea, we must first delve into the realm of quantum physics. At the subatomic level, particles exist in superposition, which can be thought of as a combination of all possible states simultaneously. When observed or measured, these states collapse into definite values. The binary nature of quantum states, the transition from superposition to a defined state, can be seen as analogous to the fundamental binary system of digital information, which is, of course, zero and one. Also, in the field of biology, the genetic code serves as a prime example of how complex organisms can be reduced to digital information. DNA, the blueprint of life, is essentially a quaternary code composed of four nucleotides, A, T, C, and G. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine. This code can be further simplified into a binary form where each nucleotide pair is represented by two bits. Thus, the entire human genome, and by extension, the instruction of building and operating a human being, can be expressed as a long string of zeros and ones, and this is would be true for any biological organism. Theoretical physicist John Wheeler proposed the concept of it from bit, suggesting that the universe is fundamentally an information processing system. In this view, every particle, every field of force, even the space-time continuum itself derives its function, its meaning, its very existence from binary choices, bits, B-I-T-S, bits from it. This idea aligns with the growing field of digital physics, which posits that the universe can be understood as a vast computational process. If we accept this premise that all existence is fundamentally digital, it raises profound questions about the nature of reality, consciousness, and free will. Are our thoughts and decisions merely the result of complex algorithms playing out in the binary code of our brains? Does digital underpinning suggest a deterministic universe, or does quantum uncertainty preserve the possibility of true unpredictability and therefore creativity and choice? This concept also has implications for fields such as artificial intelligence and virtual reality. So, where do I stand on this? I believe that consciousness itself is not digital. Its activities are digital. Consciousness is more wave-like. Schrodinger's equation is a wave function that predicts what happens upon measurement. So ultimate consciousness is not digital, but its fluctuations are digital. And this fits in very well with the yogic concept of vrittis or Shiva Shakti. Shiva is pure consciousness, and Shakti are the fluctuations of consciousness, which are digital codes that give rise to experiences, both as the human mind, the human body, and the human universe, as a unified process in the one consciousness. Let me know what you think. Digital beings, let me know what you think. You're not actually a digital being. You're an eternal being expressing yourself as a digital body, mind, and universe. I'd love your feedback. And of course, you can always go to digitaldeepak.ai if you have more queries on this. And remember, this book is coming out in September. Thank you.